Yes, good morning, ma. Today we are going to discuss about vectors. It's a part from motion in a plane, right? So now we are going to discuss about vectors. So right, in a motion in a plane, vectors. So in this, first we are going to discuss about. First we need to take about. The basics to discuss about vector. Normally, we need to know about a quantity. First, what is meant by a quantity? Quantity means it's an amount, size, or magnitude that you can call it as what? Quantity. So, first you write what is meant by quantity. Amount. Or size, or vastness, or magnitude is called quantity. Right. Next, physical quantity. Next, physical quantity. What is meant by physical quantity? Physical quantity is nothing but a quantity that can be measured is known as a physical quantity. A quantity that can be measured is a physical quantity. Quantity can be measured. Measured. Is known as a physical quantity. See, some quantities you cannot measure. So that and all, what are feelings? Feelings we can't measure. So that is not a physical quantity. Okay. Now after this, when you come to this physical quantity, so there are, we have so many physical quantities like distance, displacement, velocity, speed, acceleration, force. These are all comes under the under physical quantity. So these physical quantities are categorized into two categories. One is scalar and the other one is vector. One is a scalar and the other one is a vector. So what is scalar? A physical quantity which is having only magnitude. Physical quantity only having only magnitude is known as what? A scalar quantity. Okay. Next, what are the examples you can give? You can give examples like distance, speed, mass, time. Work done, power, etc. So these are all comes under scalar quantity. Next, you go to vectors. So vector, it is having both magnitude as well as direction. So a physical quantity which is having both magnitude and direction, okay, as well as and also it has to obey vector laws of addition. So it has to obey vector laws of addition, then only you can say that it is a vector. See, sometimes you can find some physical quantities which are having only both magnitude and direction, even though they are not vectors, since the reason is they are not obeying vector laws of addition. So that's why you can't consider there is a physical quantity which cannot be considered as a vector. So what is that example? You can give an electric current. So if you take electric current is an example for is an example which is not a vector, even though it is having both magnitude as well as direction. Okay, so that is what you can give. So how can you explain that? See here, I'll show you. Yes, next. See, here a physical quantity which is having both magnitude and direction, and also it has to obey vector laws of addition, then only we can say that it is a vector. But there is a physical quantity which is having both magnitude and direction, but even though it is not satisfying vector laws of addition, that's the reason why the electric current is not a vector, even though it is having both magnitude and direction. So then what are the examples you can give for a vector? Examples of vector is vectors, displacement, velocity, acceleration, force, momentum, like this, etc. You can give. Are the examples you can give for vectors? Okay, right. Now you go for another one. So next, a representation of a vector. A representation of vector. What is the representation of a vector? You see, a vector can be represented by an arrow. It is having two terminals. This is called what? Tail, and this is called what? Head. So tail, this is the tail and this is the head. It is having some magnitude. So this is called what? Vector. A vector which is having some magnitude and it is represented by an arrow. So this can be represented by a vector. So a vector can be represented with an arrow of certain magnitude, right? So that is about a vector. And now there are different types of vectors are there. So that we will discuss. Types of vectors. Now there are different types of vectors are there. So in that, coplanar vectors, co-initial vectors first. If I take two vectors, those two vectors are having the same initial point. So such vectors are called co-initial vectors. So you see here, this is one vector, let it be A bar, and this is another vector, let it be B bar. Okay, so or you take this is A bar and B bar are the two vectors, and so we can represent these two are co-initial vectors. So what you can say, a vector, two vectors which are having same initial point, not only two or even more also. So vectors having same initial point, having same initial point, is known as co-initial vectors. Next, co-terminal vectors. Vectors which are meeting at one point, they are called what? Co-terminal vectors. Vectors which are meeting at one point. Which are meeting at one point is known as co-terminal vectors. Next, go to coplanar vectors. Coplanar vectors. What are coplanar vectors? Vectors which are lying in the same plane. They are called what? Coplanar vectors. Vectors which are lying in the same plane are known as coplanar vectors. Lying in the same plane, or sometimes you can say even in the parallel planes also. Vectors lying in the same plane or in parallel planes. Here you can write, are known as coplanar vectors. So whatever the vectors we have drawn on the board are parallel to this board on that plane also, wherever you have drawn. So whatever you have drawn, so all the vectors are coplanar vectors only. So you can give notation like A, B, C, D, E, A bar, B bar, C bar, D bar, E bar, F bar, like. So whatever it is. So the vectors which are lying in the board plane or in your notebook plane, all are coplanar vectors only. Okay. Next. Maybe this co-initial vectors and even co-terminal vectors also comes under this coplanar vectors only. Okay, na? So coplanar, co-initial vectors also coplanar vectors. See, there is a condition. If they are lying in one plane, then you can take that plane, that vectors are coplanar vectors. Okay, co-initial vectors, even three dimension you take, you can't say that they are coplanar vectors. Okay, but in a plane you consider the co-initial vectors, then that co-initial vector in a single plane or in a parallel plane can become coplanar vectors. But in three dimension you took, they are not coplanar vectors. If you take in three dimension co-initial vectors, that co-initial vectors are not coplanar vectors, since they are not in the same plane, right? Okay. Yes, about types of vectors today. So in that, first like vectors. Two or more vectors are said to be like vectors when they are of same physical quantity parallel to each other. Okay. So however their magnitudes may be, such a physical quantities are, such vectors are called like vectors. Okay. So what are like vectors? Yes. Two or more vectors of same physical quantity are parallel to each other such physical quantities, however their magnitudes may be, are called like vectors. Okay, so two or more vectors of same physical quantity are parallel to each other, however their magnitudes may be. So such vectors are called parallel vectors. Suppose this is a vector A bar, and if I am taking another vector B bar, so may not be of same size, but they are parallel to each other. So such physical quantities are called like vectors. Next, unlike vectors. So what are the next? Unlike vectors. What are unlike vectors? Vectors are not in parallel. Such vectors are called unlike vectors. So two or more vectors, two vectors are same physical quantity. Two vectors of same physical quantity are in opposite direction to each other, however their magnitudes may be. Are called unlike vectors. So if you take one vector here, if you, this is A bar, and if I take in a vector that is B bar, so in opposite direction to each other, such vectors are called unlike vectors. So two vectors of same physical quantity are in opposite direction to each other, however their magnitudes may be, they are called unlike vectors. Okay. Next, a vector negative vector. What is a negative vector? If I take one vector here, A bar, to that exactly equal in magnitude, direction alone reverse, then that is called what? Negative vector of the given vector. So that means if a vector is given, if its direction is opposite to the given vector, then such a vector is known as negative vector. Okay. Cut. A vector of its magnitude is same and opposite in direction is called negative vector of a given vector. Okay, a vector of its magnitude is same in opposite in direction, such a vector is known as negative vector of the given vector. So if they have given a bar is one vector and you can draw opposite direction with minus a bar, so the a bar is magnitude is same but because of direction it is minus a, so then this is a negative vector. Next, next, collinear vectors what are collinear vectors? If the given vectors are acting along the same line, then such a vectors are known as collinear vectors. Two or more vectors are in the same line, then such a vectors are known as collinear vectors. Two or more vectors are along the same line, then such vectors are called collinear vectors. You see here, this is a bar, and if I take b bar, then a bar and b bar are collinear. They are acting along the same line. So you can say this is a bar here. You can take even b bar also here. Even they are in opposite direction also, you can consider as collinear vectors. So they should be acting along the same line. So it is not compulsory to be along the same direction or in opposite direction. So that is not the criteria. So that should be along the same line only. That is what collinear vectors. Next, go to unit vector. What is unit vector? A vector of its magnitude is 1 and has a specific direction such a vector is known as a unit vector. A vector of its magnitude is 1. Magnitude 1. Such a vector is known as unit vector. Suppose if a bar is given like xi cap plus yj cap plus zk cap, then unit vector for a bar is equal to a cap is equal to a bar by modulus of a bar we will write. But here we need to find what is modulus of a bar. So what is modulus of a bar? Square root of I coefficient square plus j coefficient square plus coefficient k coefficient square. So x square plus y square plus z square. That is the value of magnitude of a. So now how can we write xi cap plus yj cap plus zk cap by square root of x square plus y square plus z square. That is the value of the unit vector of given vector a cap. Next, null vector. What is null vector? A vector whose magnitude is zero is known as null vector. A vector whose magnitude is zero such a vector is known as null vector. Direction of null vector is indeterminate. You can't decide the direction of null vector. So direction of null vector is indeterminate. You cannot specify the direction of this null vector. What are the examples for it? Example you can give. What? Velocity of the particle at rest. Velocity of particle at rest. At rest. Not only that, you can write the acceleration of a particle moving with uniform velocity. You know that the uniform velocity, you know, if a particle is moving with uniform velocity, then acceleration will be zero. So that is what you can say, a bar equal to zero bar, since it is a vector, zero vector. So that is what you can represent with zero bar. Here also you can write v is equal to zero bar. V bar is zero bar, right? Next, one note point. See, if you have a vector a bar, if a bar is added with a zero vector, you will get a bar only. If you multiply that a bar with zero bar, you will get zero bar only. Okay, so this is a note point, you can note down. Next, we go for another topic. The next topic is multiplication of a vector by a real number. Multiplication of vector with real number. Right, next. See here, if you have a vector a bar, if a bar is multiplied by a positive scalar quantity, positive number like lambda, then what you will get, whose magnitude will become, then what will happen? Its magnitude is multiplied by lambda with modulus of a bar. This is the magnitude of the given vector, magnitude of the given vector, and direction remains same. Direction remain same. Because see, what we are doing is we are just multiplying that a bar with a positive scalar quantity, positive number. So like lambda, you are multiplying with a positive number, then its magnitude is multiplied by lambda times. So its magnitude is increased by or multiplied by lambda times, multiplied by lambda times, and direction remain same. So that is about with the positive number if you multiply given vector. Suppose if you multiply the vector a bar with the negative number like lambda, minus lambda, then what will happen? Its magnitude is multiplied by lambda times. So magnitude is multiplied by lambda times, like in the previous case only. Magnitude is multiplied by lambda times, but direction will be in opposite direction, since it becomes minus lambda a, that's why direction will become opposite. Next, representation of angle between vectors. See here, if I take one vector, let it be a bar, here I have taken another vector b bar, how can I measure the angle between them? So to measure the angle between two vectors, there are some conditions. First, the given vector here, this is a vector a bar, and I need to join this vector parallel to itself. So when will we measure the angle means, so the co-initial points. So if you take this vector parallel to itself, its magnitude will not change. So that means, see here, if I am bringing the magnet vector parallel to itself like this, if I draw here, so this is b bar. If I bring this vector parallel to itself, there won't be any change in the magnitude of the given vector, okay, or direction also there won't be any change. So when will it not be changed means, if a vector is shifted parallel to itself, then the vector remains same. If a vector shifts parallel to itself, then that vector remains same. Then in that situation, you can identify the initial point of this vector and the initial point of this a vector and b vector join each other. That is the first condition we need to know. So if you want to measure the angle between two vectors, then we need to make or we need to join the initial points of the two vectors. Okay, so then only we can measure the angle. That is the first point. So what is that? So first point is the angle between the initial points of the two vectors should join each other. The initial point of given vectors must meet at one point. Next, see here you can measure the angle, and at the same time here also you can measure the angle. See here you are measuring one angle theta 1, here you are measuring another angle theta 2. So which angle we need to consider in between two vectors? So you need to take the smallest angle between the two vectors, not the largest angle. So theta 2 will not be the angle between two vectors. So smallest angle theta 1 will be the angle between the two vectors. So smallest angle between two co-initial vectors smallest angle between two co-initial vectors is considered the angle is to be taken as the angle between the vectors, not the largest angle. And put it in bracket. Okay, so it is not the largest angle. It should be the smallest angle between two vectors. So like that you can represent. Suppose, see here. Here, so one application we will see. Here along x-axis, with respect to x-axis, if A bar is making an angle 30 degree, suppose with the same x-axis, another vector B bar is making an angle 30 degree. And if I take with the same x-axis, another vector C bar is making an angle 60 degree, then what are the angles between A bar and B bar, and A bar and C bar, and B bar and C bar, we need to identify. So how can we find? See here. So see, for all of them, same reference line is their x-axis. So I am taking this x is the common reference line, and with respect to that, A is making an angle 30 degrees above the x-axis, and below the x-axis B bar is taking an angle 30 degree. And now another vector, third vector, what is that? C vector, C bar, which is making an angle 60 degree with the same x-axis. Now what is the angle between A bar and B bar, and A bar and C bar, and B bar and C bar, we need to consider. Now what is the angle between A bar and B bar? What is the angle between A bar and B bar? See here, this is A bar and this is B bar. What is the total angle between these two? With above x-axis 30 degree and below x-axis 30 degree. Total 30 plus 30, 60 degree. So angle between A bar and B bar is 60 degree. Okay, na? Right. Next. Similarly, angle between B bar and C bar. See here. Angle between B bar and C bar. Angle between B bar and C bar. Now you see. So B bar and C bar, below that x-axis B bar is making an angle 30 and C bar is making an angle 60. Then angle between B bar and C bar is fully is 60. Till here it is 30. Then what about this? 30 only, na? 30 plus 30 together is 60. Okay, so then the angle between B bar and C bar is 30 degree. Here 60 degree, here 30 degree. Okay, similarly, what is the angle between A bar and C bar? Angle between A bar and C bar. See here, angle A bar is like this with respect to x-axis, that is making an angle 30 degree above, and below C bar is making with x-axis with 60 degree. So total 30 and this is 60. Total angle what? 90 degree. That is nothing but 30 plus 60, total is 90 degree. So here it is a 90 degree right angle, angle between A bar and C bar, right? So angle is 90 degree, okay, right. Now similarly, one more application we will see. See, this is x-axis. With x-axis, this is A bar is making an angle 15 degree, and B bar is making an angle above that, below that is 30 degree, and C bar is making an angle with the x-axis is 45 degree, then what is the angle between A bar, B bar and C, A bar and B bar, angle between A bar and B bar, angle between A bar and B bar, what is the value of angle between A bar and B bar? See here, A bar is here and B bar is here. What is the angle between A bar and B bar? Above that x-axis 15 degree, below that is 30 degree, total 45 degree. 15 plus 30, total 45 degree. Okay, next, you see that angle between B bar and C bar. See, below that, up to B, it is 30 degree, and up to C, it is 45 degree. Then what is the angle between these two? 45 minus this, so 15 degree. So angle between B bar and C bar is 45 minus 30, so 15 degree. Okay, next, angle between A bar and C bar, angle between A bar and C bar, you see here A to x-axis it is 15 and below that it is 45, total 15 plus 45, how much? 15 degree plus 45 degree, totally 60 degree, that is the angle between A bar and C bar. Can we take the angle between A bar and C bar is this? No. Okay, what is the angle here, A bar and C bar, this side, this direction? Up to here it is 60, then what about this remaining 300 degree, total is 360, na? So out of 360 till here it is 60, so that 60 is the smallest angle than 300, so this is the largest angle, so that you cannot take, okay, na? So that is what about that. Okay, resolution of a vector. In two dimensional plane, I am going to take the resolution of a vector. See here, this is x-axis and this is y-axis. With respect to that, this vector, let OP bar is a vector, let it be R bar, or just give notation like R bar, okay. So which makes an angle theta with this x-axis. Now this vector r bar is a vector whose magnitude is modulus of r bar. Now this r bar can be resolved into two components. So one is rx, and the perpendicular component on y axis is ry. What is rx value? Rx is equal to r cos theta. So now how can I find? See here, adjacent side. So you take this triangle, or you give the notation like OP, this is M, and this you give like N, and this is RX, okay. Now, and this is ry. Now, I am going to take from this triangle OPM. So, from triangle OPM, if you take, what is that cos theta from this triangle? Cos theta what? Adjacent by hypotenuse. So, okay, na? So, this is r bar whose magnitude is modulus of r bar is nothing but r. Okay, so cos theta is equal to what? Adjacent by hypotenuse. So, rx by r. So, from this rx equal to r cos theta. So, that means this rx value adjacent component is r cos theta. What about the perpendicular component opposite side? From this same triangle, you calculate sin theta. What is sin theta? Ry opposite side. That is, this is parallel to this, so that you can take even this is also ry. So ry opposite by hypotenuse is r. So from this ry is equal to r sin theta. So this is r sin theta and this is r sin theta. So if you want to write the vector like r bar means rx, that is along x axis, so you can represent the unit vector like I cap, rx I cap plus ry j cap. Now what is that rx value? R cos theta into I cap plus r sin theta into j cap. That is what a given vector.